we will work on other business opportunities that will depend on specific cases.
One question: if Heather's data is correct, you have to project out that there will be some significant changes in the global backbone provider business, because the market's shrinking as fast as your data is showing it shrinking. At some point, even tier one carrier can't really justify the return on operating the global network. It just doesn't make sense. You're going to have to either offload that, or there really is going to have to be some much more robust use of the hubbing and peering factors, or there's just no business there. You mean, am I wrong about that?
Invoice or IP?
Invoice.
A lot of folks are talking about outsourcing and coming up with saying if you are small, if your international business is very low, you're better off outsourcing than trying to manage it yourself. So that's what Telecom Italia is saying, and we don't tend to agree.
Yeah, it's hard to disagree
with. We don't really have a product for that, but we tend to agree. Then, I don't know, gentlemen that mentioned, I think it's a gentleman from Digicel mentioned in some countries, even though you have a very low volume of traffic, it's regulated at a very high termination. And we need to keep in mind that, again, when we look at this is international wide, there are some countries in the world today that are raising their termination price. It's not getting cheaper, it's getting more expensive. So we need to have a solution for these folks.
You also mentioned, and this is something that I know is true, but I can't always remember why it's true. David, jump in this discussion. You mentioned that termination closer to the actual end user, to the telephone number, is more efficient, costs less than terminating at a higher level. And I know this is true, but I don't understand why it's true.
Can you say that again?
David, you know what I'm saying? Okay, so the issue is, my understanding is, in terms of the economics, if you terminate down to the actual telephone number as often as you can, you're going to pay less money than if you terminate somewhere up in the network, the nearest class 5 switch or a regional center or something of that sort. And I know it's true, but I cannot remember why it's true.
Six-digit rates
versus 10-digit rates, where you have much more granular cost profiles.
Granular
routing saves money, and I know
this
true, but I don't know why.
Yeah, well, it's I don't know if it applies everywhere, but if you take the example of France, there are regulated price to where you deliver the network, where you deliver the. If you deliver an international call to an international carrier for France, it's one price. If you have a domestic license and you deliver it domestically, it's another price. If you deliver it to France Telecom and France Telecom has to deliver it to Free, which is a competitor of France Telecom, it's one price. If you deliver it to Free directly, you get another price. So it's really playing with the arbitrage and the different regulated prices on every market. But that's the whole fundamentals of the international voice business.
How much arbitrage is left here?
I think the arbitrage at the level he's talking about, kind of dial plan management, dial
right.
plan arbitrage, it's completely there, but that's still there. But as was said, the prices are going down in some areas, going up in other areas. So arbitrage itself is still a vital part of controlling the cost.
It might be more important now, actually.
Yeah, prices the revenue are going up side. Yeah.
Well, prices are going up in not in Europe and not in the U.S. They're going up in some countries in Africa, some Central America countries and stuff like that. But U.S. and Europe, they're not going up. They're going down. It's something interesting that I have with these new numbers is if you go to even in the U.S. if you get Vonage or some of these numbers, you get international numbers for free. You go to France and international numbers for free are included. You already paid for. That's becoming very common. I think that's something that we need to really look into. I understand the need for newer number plans, especially if you're calling from a PC. But other than that, there's a lot of countries where international calls from the customer are perceived from free. They're not free in the wholesale side, but from the customer, they are perceived from free.
In Telecom Italia's case, I can almost justify peering or hubbing based on all the people who are working on just maintaining the bilateral relationship alone. Forget the transmission costs. An issue.
Yeah.
Complexity. Other questions from people who want to how to play this?
Just one observation. It looks as though that
know, when you're making a decision regarding a business model, you might not have a choice but to look for opportunities where, you know, you appear for free, or, you know, and so, you know, depending upon where you're coming from, you might have different perspectives. So it isn't that there is one particular way of doing it right. Every way is fair game, and whatever works for you is what you're going to try to, you know, what you're going to try to pursue. So it depends upon what is a consistent and sustainable business model. And there are too many variables to really, you know, take a position and say you're wrong or you're right. So I think both of the views are right. I just think they're right for different reasons, which means they can coexist. But maybe, you know, they won't coexist between these two companies that have different views.
Carlos is right. It's all about the money. I mean, when I left the cable industry and came to what they call the dark side, and I've been doing this for 15 years, when I go back and see my cable friends, I say, you're still on the dark side. Right? So there's certain things they won't talk to me about anymore. And I'm not trying to overplay this conflict that's out there, but it's very serious. It's hardball. There's serious money involved, and cable guys from day one have always told me, we'll be damned if we're going to give any bell a penny of our money if we get around it. It's just, they don't want to do it.
Earlier it was talked about that they're looking for essentially cold potato routing on settlement free peering. What level of granularity for the settlement free peering that's happening now is there? I mean, is that, you know, down to, you know, the handle level, up at the ladder level, or somewhere else entirely? Kind of what granularity are we talking about?
So domestically, for us, and those that we peer with, we route on the LRN. So each company dips for portability, and then we route on the LRN.
So it's exactly the same then as you would do it on,
yeah,
on the IP side.
Yep.
Let's just go back and say one word on this peering, on the comment, the previous comment. Most of the folks that mentioned peering initially come from the internet, and this world is free and all that kind of stuff. That's fine, but when you look into the internet, peering, it's free, but not everybody peers, right? I mean, I'm sure that all of you, if most of you that have an IP network, would like to peer with Sprint, but Sprint doesn't want to peer with all of you. So, and that's the internet world, the one where people are allegedly the ones that really want to be all for free and stuff like that. So if the internet peering is not something common, it won't be something common in voice.
And I think we're out of time, unfortunately. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.